I'm sure you've heard of the new song Alejandro by Lady Gaga. Well, our model's name is Alejandra, the female version of that. And if you haven't heard of Lady Gaga, then you need to crawl out from under that rock. This week's video is inspired not only by Lady Gaga's look, but her creativity. And in this particular case, the black and white effect of her new video, Alejandro. We also took inspiration from some other images and videos. So let's take a look. We'll begin Alejandra's makeover with her color. And in order to get this Lady Gaga blonde, we'll start by applying a high-lift blonde to the root area first. Because Alejandra had previous color in her hair, we're gonna move to the second step using lifting crystals. We're gonna apply these to the dark areas first, then the second darkest areas and so forth, and then we'll let everything process evenly for approximately 40 minutes. It is important that throughout the lifting process to go back and check. For our final result has to be an even tone from the roots to the ends. If necessary, reapply lifting crystals to the end, to the darker pieces or areas that need more lifting to ensure an even result before we apply the gloss. Once we've achieved the desired lifting level, we'll go ahead and rinse out the solution. Then we'll go ahead and apply a gloss with a pigmented base to even out the tone to ensure we have a beautiful blonde. Now we're moving on to the haircut. And to stay on track with our inspiration, which of course is Lady Gaga, we gotta see things from a different angle. And speaking of angles, that's exactly where we're gonna start. Establishing a really strong line, a perimeter, starting from the back of the ear in an angle diagonally forward towards the chin. Next, we taper the nape area. And we do this by taking every section and over-directing it towards the back center. This keeps it short but maintains length on the outer edges, making the angle more evident. It's time to connect everything. And we'll start by taking the top section. You'll comb everything back and up once you get to the crown area, elevating the hair and connecting all the loose edges. We'll do the same for both sides, except when we get to the sides, we'll start combing the hair from behind the ear and up towards the crown, and again, connecting any loose ends. We'll do that for both sides. What happens is that your haircut's now connected, and you won't lose the angle that we created at first. Using a combination of texturizing scissors and point cutting, we're really gonna emphasize the angle by removing as much bulk from the occipital bone up. And we'll repeat this process when the hair is dry. To complete this look, we need lots of volume and texture. We'll begin by mixing a volume cream and a conditioning oil. Then we'll apply this mixture to the root area first, combing the remainder of the product through the ends. Now using a blow drying round brush, we'll focus our drying first on the root area, again to create as much volume as possible. Once the hair is dry, and just before we set the style, we're gonna go back to the area I spoke about earlier on, which is from the nape area, just above the occipital bone. And using the same technique, which is the texturizing scissors, in a combination with point cutting, we are gonna soften up that area once again. You'll definitely get to see the angle now, and the final look.
Oh,
For your very own celebrity-inspired look, please visit biblosalon.com.